Navy submarine commander. Join me from Sarasota in Florida. The list, I mean, one, the Coast Guard says there's always hope, but the list of challenges and difficulties are pretty enormous.
Yeah, so, but it's not 0% chance of recovering them. And I think one of the challenges is getting solved. The Navy has a system which has a long cable that's designed to be portable. So it's disassembled, it's flown in big airplanes. That's happened. They've gone to Newfoundland. They've been loaded on a ship and that ship is heading out. So if they are found, the search part, the rescue part, the piece for the rescue part will be in place. The ship should arrive out there. There was a press conference by the company that operates that ship, and they think the ship's going to be out there early in the morning. Now, that's desperately close to when the oxygen will run out, but it's still possible. But we need to find them.
Is it your thinking, and I fully understand that we don't know the deep, you know, the pardon the phrase, the nuts and the bolts, but is it your thinking that this craft will be somewhere between surface and the bottom, and it won't actually have dropped to the bottom?
I think that's incredibly unlikely. That would mean it would be exactly neutrally buoyant. That's very unlikely if the systems work. Now, this craft has several ways to get up to the surface. It can drop ballast. It can detach the legs. It can inflate balloons. It can use the propellers. They'll either work and get it to the surface, or if it's negatively buoyant, if it's heavier than the ocean, then it will sink to the bottom. It would be incredibly unlikely for it to be just exactly buoyant and somehow floating in the middle of the water column. It's either on the surface or it's on the bottom.
Right. Now, again, it's because of it's difficult to understand, because I sort of think this thing of, well, if it's come to the top, if it's floating on the water because of its buoyancy, why can't we see it? I mean, surely you fly enough, if you fly enough and you've got satellites and you've got everything, we've got all this sophisticated technology. If it is buoyant on the surface, why is it so difficult to see?
Yeah, it's, let's say you get an egg, a hard-boiled egg, and it's floating in the pan. Not much of the egg. It's not like the egg is sitting on top of the water. The egg is in the water and just barely is this tiny little bit that's above the water. And that's basically what we're dealing with here. The vast majority of this thing is going to be underwater. I did see pictures of it that have some sort of an antenna, or maybe it's a periscope that they can raise to look out when they're driving around on the surface. But that's a pretty small thing. Right. And hopefully they've been able to do that. But it's harder than you would think to find something sitting in the water. And then there's other things that distract us. There's just debris, things that might seem attractive. We go check it out, we spend resources, they're not there.
Because we don't know what's happened, I'll concede that my next question might be marginally unfair, but you will have read the criticisms of this craft and ocean and how they have dealt it. So would you have gone down on it?
No. I would not have gone down. There's a number of reasons. For me, you're taking on huge personal risk, and it's not offset by a compensatory gain. Right. Being in the vicinity of the Titanic, but just looking at it sort of through a tiny peephole doesn't really attract me. Sure. And there's not a lot of physical endeavor here. Climbing a mountain, you need stamina, endurance, physical agility. But here you just need to endure sitting cross-legged in an uncomfortable position for 7 hours.
Sir, I'm grateful to you. Thank you. I appreciate it.